Many phishing attacks take place on social business networks, such as LinkedIn, where you and many of your colleagues are selected as targets for attacks on the basis of your jobs and positions. You may receive the following email in which you're offered the opportunity to test new mobile devices. As a thank you, you get to keep, for example, the brand new tablet. All you have to do is log on briefly to confirm your participation. But hurry, only a limited number of people can take part. So, what do you do? Wow, a brand new tablet for a bit of product testing? Of course I'm in! So, you click on the link. You see our typical layout with a logon box. You enter your username and password and you've fallen into the trap. But how do you recognize such an attack? Let's look at it in detail. Opening an email is safe enough, but don't click on any links or attachments, at least not yet. Let's examine the email. Don't trust the sender. Email senders are easy to forge. Check the layout and writing style. Poor layout and spelling mistakes are signs of many phishing emails. This isn't the case in our example attack, however. Check the salutation. Are you being addressed directly or does the email start with "Dear User"? Non-specific salutations generally suggest phishing. And now for the content. Phishing emails always include a request for action. That means clicking on a link or opening an attachment, and you have to do it now. It will be to your disadvantage if you don't react quickly enough. Your user account will be deleted, or as in our case, you'll miss out the free tablet. This buildup of pressure is a very strong sign of a phishing attack. And now for the most important point. Check the link you're meant to click on carefully. Hover the mouse over the link and look at the pop-up window. The real link appears here. This link cannot be forged, and now we can dissect it. Every website starts with either HTTP or HTTPS. The S stands for secure. That means an encrypted link. And that's important, as without the S, your password would fly through the internet in plain text. However, for HTTPS, you need a certificate, which means you have to register, then install, and so on. That's way too complicated for some attackers, which is why a few phishing links start only with HTTP. So here's our first rule. If the link starts only with HTTP, then it already smells like phishing. If it starts with HTTPS, then it doesn't mean anything at all, unfortunately, as it could be a real link or a really good fake link. Now let's look at the actual link, which is always put together as follows. HTTP or HTTPS, double point, double slash, possibly something here, .destinationaddress.com/something here too. The crucial bit for us is the destination address. Everything else is irrelevant. If you receive an email from PayPal, the destination address should also be PayPal. And this is how you identify the destination address. Start at the double slash. Look for the next slash. Move the eye back along the link, jumping over the ending .com or .net, and look for the next dot. The destination address is always between this dot and the first slash. Whatever comes afterwards is completely irrelevant. Let's practice this. Here we have an alleged PayPal link. Does it lead to PayPal? Only HTTP, that already smells like phishing. We go from the double slash to the first slash, jump back over the ending and look for the first dot. Mybankdetails.com is the destination address, not PayPal, so that's phishing. Now the link from our example attack. Check it out yourself. Do you see the small differences? It looks very similar, but still leads to a completely different destination. Last attempt with a Deutsche Bank email. HTTPS, that's a good start. And again, we go from the double slash to the first slash, jump back over the ending and look for the first dot. Deutsche-Bank.com. That fits. No phishing this time. If in doubt, better play it safe and avoid clicking on the link. If you really are a Deutsche Bank customer, open the page via your list of favorites, or simply enter www.deutsche-bank.com in your web browser. That's still the most secure way to operate. And very importantly, if instead of a link, an email has an attachment along the lines of here is your reminder, or please complete this form, then on no account open the attachment. In most cases, it will contain malware. And if you're not sure, report the suspicious email to us. Help us to ensure security in our company. We are counting on you.